Hi, in this video we will learn how to print different types of pattern using Python programming. When you search internet, you may come across many pattern with lengthy code. Question is, do you need to remember all the pattern coding? My answer is no. Then how to print different patterns? First thing is that one should understand the basics of for loop and nested for loops. With this knowledge, understanding the given pattern, then think of writing the code. In this video, I'll explain you how to print different square patterns. First, let me start with a simple square pattern so that it will help us to improve the way of thinking about the logic for printing the complex patterns. Now let me start with one simple square pattern of 5 cross 5 without using any iterative loops. As the required pattern is 5 cross 5, use 5 print functions with 5 stars as a argument. As we need output in 5 lines, so I am using 5 print functions and output is 5 cross 5 square pattern. Now you can see the output. In place of star, one can print hash, one can place @ symbol, or whatever you want you can place in the print function. This is a simple way, but printing the patterns with multiple print function is not recommended. Now we will see printing the square pattern by using nested for loop. First, count the number of rows and the number of columns given in the pattern. In this example, the number of rows are 5 and the number of columns are 5. First, let me take one for loop with the range 1 to 6. It will iterate for 5 times. And let me call this is the outer loop, and the outer loop will decide number of rows to be printed. Now let me take one more for loop with the range 1 to 6. This will also iterate 5 times. Let me call this as an inner loop, and the inner loop decides the number of columns to be printed. Yes, I am using a print function. I want to print the stars inside the pattern, hence I am using the star in the print function. Let me check the output now. Oops, the output is not what we expected. Yes, let me change the code. I am using a outer for loop. This will decide the number of rows to be printed. Inner for loop decides the number of columns to be printed. Now the print function with end attribute is used. Let me check the output. No again. Now also the output is not what we expected. Yes, we are missing a small logic over here. After completing 5 iterations of inner for loop, start printing in new line by adding an empty print function. Similarly, after printing next 5 stars, use one more print function. Next after 5 stars, one more print. Next after 5 stars, one more print. So that we can get a square pattern what we expected. Outer for loop decides the number of rows to be printed. The range 1 to 6 will iterate for 5 times. Inner loop with the range 1 to 6 will also iterate for 5 times. I am using a print function with end attribute as the argument and one empty print function, so that after completing the inner for loop, the cursor will start from the new line. It's in the form of table. We'll see what's the values of A and B during the each iteration. During the first iteration, the value of A is 1 and the value of B is changing from 1 to 5. Hence, in the output, you are going to get the 5 stars. As we used a print function after executing an inner for loop, the cursor will start from the new line. Now the value of A will be 2, and again the inner for loop will execute 5 times And in the output, we are going to see the 5 stars. After completing an inner for loop, we are going to execute the print function once again. Again, the cursor will occupy the new line. Hence, during the next iteration, the value of A will be 3. The value of B will be varying from 1 to 5. In the output, you are going to get the 5 stars. Again, the print function is executed. The cursor will take the new line. Now, the value of A will be 4. Inner loop will iterate for 5 times. In output, you are going to get 5 stars. Then the print function is executed. Again, the cursor will start from the new line. The value of A will be 5. The inner loop value B will be changing from 1 to 5. In the output, you are going to get the 5 stars. Similarly, we will try to print one more pattern as shown. The pattern is a bit different here, even though it is a square pattern. In first line, you have all 1s, second line, all 2s, third line, all 3s, fourth line, all 4s, and fifth line, all 5s are there. Count number of rows. The number of rows are 5. Similarly, count the number of columns. The number of columns are 5. Yes, you need to take a nested for loop. This is the outer for loop, which iterates 5 times. In each iteration, the value of A will be changing from 1 to 5. This is the outer loop, decides the number of rows. This is the inner for loop. This is also iterated 5 times. The value of B will also varies from 1 to 5. Inner for loop decides number of columns to be printed. Next, the print function. In the print function, we have taken A as a variable with the end attribute and one print function. We'll see how the execution will goes. With the help of this table, we'll try to analyze what will be the printed in the output. During first iteration, the value of A will be 1. The inner loop will iterate for 5 times. During each iteration, the value of B is changing from 1 to 5. In the output, A is the variable. A is printed 5 times because the inner loop iterate 5 times. After completing inner for loop, a print function will be executed so that the cursor will take the new line. During next iteration, the value of A will be 2 and the inner for loop will execute 5 times. Each time in the output, 2 will be printed. After completing inner for loop, the print function will be executed. Hence, the cursor again will take the new position. During the next iteration, the value of A will be 3 and inner loop will iterate for 5 times. During each iteration in the output, we are going to print the number 3. After completing all 5 iterations, again the empty print function will be executed. So again the cursor will take the new line. Now the value of A will be 4. Inner loop will iterate for 5 times. During each iteration in the output, we are going to print the 4. After printing all 4s, empty print function will be executed. Hence, again, the cursor will take the new line. Now, the value of A will be 5. Inner loop it iterates for 5 times. In the output, we are going to get 5 5s. And finally, the output you can see first line all 1s, second line all 2s, and so on. Fifth line all 5s. We'll try with one more type of square pattern. There are total of 5 rows with 5 columns. In each row, the numbers 1 to 5 should be printed. Select two for loops, outer for loop which iterates 5 times and decides number of rows to be printed during each iteration. The value of A changing from 1 to 5. Inner for loop, it also iterates for 5 times and decides the number of items to be printed during each iteration. And then the print function with variable B and end attribute is used as an argument. And one empty print function so as to start printing the numbers in a new line after completing the inner loop iteration. Let us see the what values does the variables A and B holds during each iteration. During first iteration, the value of A will be 1, the value of B will be changing from 1 to 5. In print function, we placed a variable B. Hence, in output, the number 1 to 5 will be printed. After completing the inner iteration, the print function will be executed. During second iteration, the value of A will be 2 and the value of B is varying from 1 to 5. Again, in print function, as we place b as a variable, in the output we are going to get a numbers 1 to 5. After completing an inner for loop, print function will be executed and the cursor will be waiting in the new line. Similarly, in the third iteration, the value of a will be 3, inner loop will iterate for 5 times. In each iteration, the values 1 to 5 will be printed. Then the print function will be executed so that the cursor will be placed at the new line. Similarly, now the value of a will be 4. So inner loop will iterate for 5 times. In each iteration, the numbers 1 to 5 will be printed. And then print function is executed. Next, again, the value of a will be 5. And inner loop iterates again 5 times. In the output, we are going to print the numbers 1 to 5. So the output is what we expected. Still now, we printed a special symbols and numbers in the square pattern. Now let us try printing an alphabets in the square pattern. Again, there are 5 rows with 5 columns. Take 2 for loops, outer for loop and the inner for loop. Outer for loop will decide number of rows and the inner for loop decides the number of columns during each iteration. In a print function, instead of using variable a or variable b or using star or special character, we are using chr function. The chr function will returns the character that represent the specific unique code. Here we are taken 64 plus a. Initially the value of a will be 1. 64 plus 1 65. Chr of 65 is capital A. And then one empty print function. Now we'll see how the execution will takes place and what the values of a and b will be hold during each iteration. During first iteration, the value of a will be 1. Inner loop will iterates for 5 times. In the output, 64 plus 1, 65. CHR of 65 is a. Hence, 5 a's are printed. Then print function is executed. Next, the value of a will be 2. Inner loop iterates for 5 times. 64 plus 2 is CHR of 64 plus 2 is b. In the output, we are going to print the 5 b's. And again, the print function will be executed. My cursor will start from the new line. Hence, the value of a will be 3. Inner loop will iterate for 5 times. In the output, we are going to get 64 plus 3, 67. CHR of 67 is C. In the output, we are going to print 5 C's. Similarly, next print function will be executed. Next, the value of a 4. And inner loop will iterate for 5 times. C 64 plus 4, 68. CHR of 65 is D. In the output, we are going to print 5 D's. After completing an inner for loop, the print function will be executed and the cursor will start printing the characters from the new line. At last loop, the value of A will be 5. Inner loop will iterate for 5 times. 64 plus 5, that is 69. CHR of 69 is E. So in the output, in the first line, we are printing all A's, second line all B's and so on. In the last line, all E's. Instead of printing all A's in the first row, all B's in the second row, we'll try to print alphabets A to E in first line, second line, third line, fourth line and fifth line. Here the number of rows are 5 and the number of columns are 5. Take 2 loops, outer for loop. It reads for 5 times. It decides number of rows to be printed. Inner loop will also iterate for 5 times. And it decides the number of elements to be printed. Next, one print function. Instead of taking 64 plus A, now we have taken 64 plus B. And one empty print function. We'll see how the execution will goes during each iteration. Now we'll see what the values of A and B will hold during each iteration. During first iteration, the value of A will be 1. The B is changing from 1 to 5. CHR of 64 plus B. During first iteration of inner for loop, 64 plus 1, that is A will be printed. Next, 64 plus 2, B will be printed. Next, 64 plus 3. C will be printed. Next 64 plus 4, D will be printed. Next 64 plus 5, E will be printed. After completing an inner for loop, the print function is executed. The cursor will start from the new line. This is the values of A and inner loop values and the output. Again, the print function is executed. Next, this is the value of next. This is the value of A. Inner for loop will iterate for 5 times. In the output, we are going to get the alpha bits starting from A to E. Again, the print function is executed. The cursor will start from a new line. Now, A will hold the value 4. Inner loop will iterate for 5 times. In the output, we are going to get the alpha bits A to E. A will hold the value 4. Inner loop will iterate for 5 times. During each iteration, the characters A to E will be printed. Next, again the print function is executed. The cursor will be start printing from a new line. A will hold the value 5. Inner loop will iterate for 5 times. In the output, you are going to get the characters A to E. This is how you can print any square pattern.